hey, we're in Chicago and we're headed to Miami. We're jumping on this big airplane and we're flying down there for our pre-cruise day in Miami. Tomorrow we're going to be jumping on the Norwegian Prima for an inaugural cruise. And as always, we're headed to the port city a day in advance so we are sure that we do not miss that ship. Bayside Market Place, downtown Miami. We made it here. Nicole is gone. No hurricane for us. Right? That make you happy?
Yes.
So, Bayside Market Place. Been here a bunch of times before. Tons of shops. All kinds of stuff. Everything you can imagine. 3D laser land. That's some pretty cool stuff. Expensive. But we're headed to get some food. We need some food. We are hungry. We're looking for the Cuban restaurant. Eaten there before. Very good food. Wow. How about some
gelato?
Gelato. Can you say gelato? Mambo Cafe. Is there an echo? I'm echoing you. Lola. There's all kinds of food down here, more than the first time I was here. Bruschetta, mozzarella sticks, the Land Shark Bar and Grill.
No, not that one.
No. I'm in Miami, I want Cuban food. Welcome to Miami. We're here grabbing a little bit of lunch down at Bayside Marketplace. Pretty loud, I don't know if you could hear me. Cubano sandwich. And I don't remember what they're called, but they are basically mashed potatoes. One of them has ham in it, surrounded by mashed potatoes and deep fried. The other one has ground beef, surrounded by mashed potatoes and deep fried. There you go, a little Cuban appetizer. Pretty good. Cubano sandwich is good.
I've had better. Actually had one better in Milwaukee last week. But I think this one is a little more authentic than the one in Milwaukee at the Great Lakes Distillery. But that one was pretty darn awesome there. So it's doing good, thanks.
Good, thanks.
Just checking the weather here. It's partly cloudy. Hurricane Nicole is gone. It's 83 degrees and pretty darn humid here in Miami. I keep saying Milwaukee. We are in Miami, not Milwaukee. So yeah, 83 degrees, humid, partly cloudy. Hurricane Nicole is gone somewhere up in Georgia, I think. Flight down here was good. It got a little rough, I think, over Georgia, coming over the Gulf. They kind of diverted over the Gulf instead of the route over Florida. So must have been some remnants there, but pretty good flight. We were in a 787. We had 9 across seating in there. I've got the video for that. Haven't been in one of those before. And unbelievable power. When that thing took off out of Chicago, I can't believe how quickly that thing lifted off the runway after we picked up speed. Just unbelievable power. So pretty cool plane. All the seats had little TVs with movies and music and games. Wi-Fi wasn't included, but the window shades were some kind of funky push button that it actually darkened the glass. I don't know how that worked, but yeah, they were like glass darkening window shades. Kind of weird, but it really did get dark. So, well, we are in It's Sugar, a store here in Bayside and Market Place. And what caught my eye? What caught my eye was those dingleberries. But they have every kind of candy you can imagine. A giant gummy worm. Make your own bears kit. Oh, a big old Rice Krispie treat. Toxic waste. Cookie doll bites. And the funniest part of it all is that I'm in here shopping in a candy store drinking a mojito. Where else but Miami can you do that? They are all ready for Christmas down here. Well, maybe not all ready, but they definitely have a start on it. Here's the Bayside banyan tree. Say it. What is it?
Ooh. He's ugly.
Hey there, little friend. Leanne wants to hold you.
No, I do not.
Uh-huh. Well, we're getting ready to take a ride on the Miami Metro Mover. It's operated by Miami Dade Transit. It's a free mass transit that loops around downtown in the Brickell area in Miami on a 4.4 mile track. So we're gonna check out some of the architecture and sights of Miami while we rest our feet, because we've already put on about 14,000 steps today. So we're a little tired of walking. So come along and join us as we ride the Miami Metro Mover. Welcome to Yotel. Here is our room in Miami. This is pretty wild.
Kind of weird, huh?
Yeah.
Where's the bathroom?
It's in there. Ain't no privacy here, I'll tell you that.
Did that go down? Ah, the light goes on.
That one's a shower.
Oh, yeah.
So we got the shower and I won't say. Let's give this room a proper look over here. Welcome to Miami. Kind of a unique bed here.
Oh, wow.
Got some, I guess those are just chargers over there. I didn't know if they're kind of some kind of buttons that did something weird. They're just outlets and chargers right by the bed.
Oh, which reminds me, I need to charge my phone.
And it's all in one space. Here's the sink. There we go, put some light on the subject. And if I step in the bathroom and turn around, there's the bedroom. This could be embarrassing if you don't like what you do. And there's a shower, and it's got urban jungle shampoo, conditioner, hand and body wash, and it's got a rain shower head and a handheld. And then if you don't like that room, you just close the door and you're back in the bedroom. And if you open this door, you have the king's
throne,
or the queen's throne. We'll leave it at that. And then you just turn around and you're back in the room. So if we do if I had Tony's 360 camera here, you'd be able to see it all at once.
Right.
I could just spin. Hey, Tony Barnett, La Lita Loca, have you stayed at a Yotel? The Yotel Notel. Hey, all joking aside, our stay at the Yotel Miami was pretty awesome. It started out with they had self-check-in. Actually, we got there early. we were able to check our bags and explore the city. We went off to Bayside Market and had lunch. When we did come back and our room was ready, we were able to check in ourselves at a kiosk. You actually make your own keys, so pretty expedited process there. They did have a restaurant in the hotel. We didn't dine there, but the food looked awesome, as did everything we looked on the menu. It was pretty good. The whole place was pretty modern. You had to use your key to get to your floor for your room. If God forbid you got on the elevator and didn't press your key because it sounded like you might get stuck in there or something. I don't know. Some people were talking about it, but we had no problems. And the room was very comfortable. Yes, it was close quarters in there. The bathroom wasn't very private, but no big deal. The bed was fantastic. It actually, the buttons on it actually lifted your feet and your head, so it was kind of nice. And we did use the pool there. The pool here, very comfortable. Nobody was up there. This was Thursday night, so pretty quiet in downtown Miami at that date. And the pool and the whirlpool were fantastic because at that point we had put on over 16,000 steps. So we'd walked a little over 8 miles that day. And that pool was just what we needed. So, again, a great stay at the Yotel Miami, a new hotel. It was actually, the rate was very competitive too. I think it's like $288 it cost us for downtown Miami for a night. So worked out really well. You can see that beautiful downtown Miami at night. A little bit of walking we did, but no filming while we were doing that. So anyway, onward to the Norwegian Prima in the morning. So be sure to watch for our videos on our cruise on the Norwegian Prima. It's an inaugural sailing, so it's just a short 3-day cruise, but we're really looking forward to it. And if you haven't already done so, we'd really appreciate it if you'd subscribe to our channel, like our videos if you like them, obviously, and be sure to ring that notification bell so you'll know when new videos are published on our channel. Have a great day, everyone.